and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the If I Produce 4 series. Today we're going to cover the Migos. Now the Migos are known for their turn-up style and their triplet rhyming that, you know, became a very influential flow for hip-hop. So what they do is when they rap in triplets, like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, you know. My diamonds came in from Africa, you know, a lot of three-syllable words. So we want to, you know, give them room to create that kind of flow. And to do that, we're going to start with the typical Southern bounce. And we're also going to do a specific thing with the rhythm that they do a lot in their songs, which is to do the ending of a bar. It goes, dun, dun, pew, and then it kind of stops. It either does a fade down as far as tape stop, or it does like a complete mute. So that those are the two elements you want to focus on as far as your drum rhythm. I'll show you the Southern bounce rhythm in a second. So you want to get to a danceable tempo, which is about 135 BPM. You know, that's like a turn up tempo bass. We're going to use only FL Studio stuff. So let's go to PAX. We're going to go to Legacy. Let's go to Drums. Let's go to Vintage Drums. In here, we have a rim shot from the 808 drum machine. So we're going to use that as our bouncing element. This used to be what people use for the bouncing element. Nowadays they use snares, so you can use that or a snare, but we're going to use that specifically. Now let's grab a snare, which is an 808 snare. This one's a little brighter, a little more high frequency content, so let's use that one. And we need a clap. Now there should be a different clap. Let's go to dance. I'm going to look for a different clap. Let's see here. I'm going to use this one, okay? Dance clap 2. This is more of an 808 clap as well. You can layer that in. Okay, let's go back to our vintage drums. And we might pick a kick from BusyWorksBeats.com to keep it modern. But we can grab a hi-hat from here. So let's see. Here's a hi-hat right under the vintage tab. You're going to see a lot of songs use these vintage drums. And let's grab that cymbal. What else can we grab? Tom drum we're not going to use for the most part. Trying to think. We can use an open hat maybe. And all we need now is just a kick. This kick's a little clicky for me, so that's why I'm trying to avoid it for this track. Let's try the hip hop folder. I don't think it has the kick I'm looking for, but let's just try anyway. Okay, they're very specific kicks. They have a lot of body, so we might have to go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's go to the X drum kit. Let's load up some kicks. And I already know kick IH is going to work well in this genre. So I'm going to grab that. Okay, so let's pull these up. I'm going to send these to individual tracks, one through whatever. And to see these, if you don't see these, just hit Alt M. And also you need to have the newest edition of FL Studio. So FL 11, I don't think has that function. It may, so try it. Alt plus M shortcut will hide or reveal these numbers to the side. Okay, so now we have all the elements. Let's start with the rhythm, then let's move into the instrumentation. So firstly, let's do the rim shots, and then we'll do the kick drum and the hi-hat pattern. So it goes boom, tap, click, click, tap, boom, tap, click, click, tap. So let's do it to the metronome. Boom, tap, click, click. Now this is a little slow, so let's speed it up. Boom, tap, click, click, tap. Boom. So that's the bounce. So we're going to use that rim shot as a bouncing element to push us through the snare pattern. Let's put the snare on the 3 and the 7, layered with the claps. Now you can also bounce your snare. Since this is a pretty short snare, you can bounce that as well, meaning. But I want that rim shot to be a very specific element, so we're going to let it stand by itself. Now let's layer claps over top of the snare. I'm going to go into the mixer and just turn the volume down for the claps, because everything can't be loud. Okay, but we need that kind of clap combo to thicken up the sound a little bit. Now, another technique you can do for the claps is go to your wrench tool, turn up time shift just a little bit. So when you're layering these sounds, they don't all fall at the same exact spot. You know, we're going to give each sound room to breathe. Okay, so now let's add a kick. So I want to go A lot of Migos stuff is either do do doom doom ch doom ch ch doom ch doom do doom doom, or you can go boom boom ch boom. You know, it's a very common dance pattern. Here's the dance pattern: boom 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 boom. That's just the common dance pattern all the time. Boom boom ch boom 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 ch boom boom, and variations of that. So that's where it all stems from. So you're going to see variations of that. So let's do ba-da-dum, boom, sh, boom. So I'm going to clone this because I don't want the kick to always hit as a triplet. Okay, so pattern two, we're going to have it hit regular. First pattern, we're going to have it hit with that, shouldn't have said triplet, sorry, the three-note kick. Let's go to our playlist. Let's add this into the playlist. I'm going to change my snap to grid to bar mode. Let's right click our pattern source, or you can go up here, select the pattern clip source. We're gonna go to pattern one. So it goes 2-1, let's hit control B to latch paste. Let's go to the playlist mode, hitting that button here. Now let's go to pattern three and come up with a hi-hat pattern. Now here's the key to a lot of Southern bounce is actually in the hi-hat rhythm that you use. So you gotta be really careful how you do your hi-hats. You could just do an easy right click, fill each two steps, which is this t-t-t-t-t-t-t. But it really depends on the artist, okay? So if you wanna kinda dictate the groove, you have to create a very unique hi-hat pattern. So think in your head, how would you, let's beatbox it before we even add it. Remember, they're gonna be rapping in triplets, so they're gonna be like, so they're trying to fit in the groove, so you need to give room for that groove. So that's how they rap. You could do triplet hi-hats, so just keep that in mind. What we're gonna do here, let's do, let's just do the kick pattern. So I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3, and we're just gonna repeat that. Let's go to pattern four. Let's add that down symbol, the symbol on the downbeat. Let's add that in. A downbeat is when you start a new bar. Also, we need to pitch those two to match because they're not tuned the same. One's going bing, the other one's going ti-ti-ti. So it's two different pitches. So we either need to pitch up the cymbal or pitch down the hi-hat. That fits a little bit better. Now keep in mind, what everybody tries to do in every, you know, modern genres, make the kick the loudest thing. The kick doesn't always need to be the loudest thing. Okay, so your kicks and snares don't need to be chopping through a mix all the time. That's why people sound the same. It's because they're mixing the same way. Their mixing philosophy doesn't change for each song. So, I mean, you can do whatever you want, but having to kick the loudest thing all the time is not always the solution. Let's see what else. Did we miss anything? I think we're good on the drums, the hi-hat, the open hi-hat. Let's see where we can squeeze that in if we're going to use it. So for the open hi-hat, let's go to the envelope tool. The reason I'm here is because I only want it to play for a short amount of time. Instead of going, playing the whole sample, I want it to go and then stop. So let's go to volume envelope. Let's turn that on. Let's turn the hold parameter all the way up. And now when I play a key and let it go, it stops. Now you can use the hold parameter or sustain. They're both doing the same exact thing. So you don't have to use hold. You can use sustain, okay? So. Okay, now one more pattern we're gonna add is on the eighth bar. So every sequence of four things. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4 segments. We're gonna change that drum pattern. So let's make that unique, so it's a new pattern. And what I'm gonna do is have the kick fall on the beats, the beat count for the last beat. Okay. So that's usually their pattern. And here they're probably going to leave out a snare too. But let's keep the snare in, I guess, for the frequency content. And here you would do like a tape stop effect. I'll show you how to do that in FL Studio specifically. The thing is, I don't have the full version of Gross Beat. You could, I guess, do it with the tempo, but that might get a little too crazy. Or you could do it with the master pitch. We'll try. Let's just see. Just want to show you how to do it. Now for the hi-hats, they're two on the grid. Now a lot of Southern music has swing to it. Or not swing to it, I mean it has groove to it. And the reason they create groove is time difference. So let's go to the hi-hat, let's go to the wrench tool, let's turn up time shift. This is going to delay the hi-hats behind the rhythm and create an invisible groove. And people don't realize this is where the groove, this is where that bounce actually comes from. So I'm going to add the open hi-hat on the and, so it goes one, and two, and. Okay, so we can just add it, you know, whenever we want it. Okay, now again, we need to, since we have the sustain parameter on, or hold parameter, we need to give it a note length to tell it when to stop. So I send it to piano roll so I can give it a note length, so it doesn't play its whole sample. Also, we need to time delay it. Let's go to the wrench tool, turn up that time shift. And we could turn it down in the mix. So let's go to our mixer, just turn it down. And the hi-hat does not need to be the loudest element either. Now at the end, I want to go dun, dun, buh, buh, buh. So let's do a three hit of the kick instead. Okay, now we didn't add the 808, which I meant to grab from BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's go to our browser. Let's go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's go to 808 Science Drums. We have over 40 808s from the industry. Let's figure out which one fits this song. Now, if you want a short kind of Southern 808, I already know by, you know, from memory, the 808 enzyme is the one to choose. But we need to tune this 808, so let's right click. Let's go to edit. It's going to open up Edison, where we can tune, where we can find the pitch of the 808. Now we have videos on this, so if you're confused still, go to type in 808 slides BusyWorks Beats, or you can also view the pitching tutorial or tuning tutorial. Just type in tuning BusyWorks Beats, it'll pop up the full video. So let's go to the marker tab. Let's go to detect pitch regions. This one's in the key of E. You usually pick the longer one. Okay, so even though it says G sharp, we're going to pick the longer section. So that says E. So let's go to envelope. We're going to reset any root note that may be set, and we're going to right click and set the root note to E. So now when we play our keys, we're playing the right keys. That's important because if you're looking at MIDI and referring to your MIDI, you could be thinking that you're playing a certain note when you're not, and it can confuse you tremendously if you don't tune your 808s. Okay, so let's add this 808. I'm going to start with the 808 rhythm, not the notes, just the rhythm, and then we're going to go back and, you know, give it a note value. Notice this one's like boom, very short decay time. So you don't have to overdo the 808s. That's another thing about this style. You don't have to go ham, you know, with the 808s. You can leave some gaps for the rhythm. Now I want the second pattern to be a little bit different, so let's make that unique. And I want this to go boom, boom, boom. So this is one genre where it's okay to mimic the kick pattern. Usually with 808s, you don't make them as active as kicks. Okay, so now we're gonna actually make it as active as our kick with three hits here. Okay. Now if you're having issues with overlapping samples, you wanna right click, make sure it says cut itself. Let's clone this over. Now for the fourth segment here, we're going to make that last pattern unique. And we need to match the energy of that kind of wrap-up section. here you can, for the 808, it doesn't have to match the kick. You can add like an octave note here if you wanted to. But remember, tape stop will be taking effect, so it might not even be optimal to put anything there. So I like the tone, but it just needs to change the root note. So let's go to our pattern 7. Let's right click, go to piano roll. Let's pull this up 2 octaves so we can actually hear the tone, so you can understand what I'm talking about. And let's start back over. You know, that's not matching our key or our tone of the song yet. Actually, C might be a good place to start. Let's try it. Okay, so I guess we got lucky on that one. But usually, when you have music already laid down, you're going to have to match your 808 with the music. But there's no music laid down, so you know there's nothing to match it to. I just wanted to make sure that tone was proper. And notice we're using a low octave for the 808. Another trick for the 808 is you can go to your time shift and turn up, go to your wrench tool and turn up time shift just a little bit. You don't want to overly do it. But having that tiny bit of lag is going to create that groove. I've heard this in a lot of Southern music before trap was even popular. They would add an attack to their 808. I guess it was to get out of the way of the kick, but it became a sound. So notice the 808's very kind of separated from the kick. Now it sounds good on the spaced out notes, but when it hits the 3 notes in a row, it sounds a little weird. So we might pull back that time shift a bit. This is a group you're not going to add too much 808 saturation. They're not going for an aggressive, edgy tone. They're going for just a bounce. So as long as you create that bounce with those bouncy snares patterns that I showed you. Now I'm also going to tune the rim shot because it's very high pitched. I'm going to pull it down. So it should be bum, bum. Okay, we want to match the key of the song. Okay, now let's go into the instrumentation. You could put synths behind it. It's really down to the rhythm with these guys. You really have free palette, free roam. But let's just say we wanted to add piano. Let's go to, I'm not going to load up Keyscape because it just takes too long to load ups for my setup. So let's go to, I guess, Nexus. Let's open up. Actually, I said I was going to keep this FL based. There isn't too many good FL pianos by default. There is one in the, let's go to PAX. Let's go to Instruments. Let's go to keyboard, let's go to grand piano or stage grand or close grand, either one. Let's try grand piano first. Now this is a little bit different than FL keys because they sample the piano, but still I usually would pick a different style piano. So let's play around with the piano with the song just to hear what it would sound like. I think that's a cool pattern. Bah, 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 bah. And I'll show you what we're doing behind the scenes. Let's record notes in automation. I'm basically doing two octaves of A with my left hand to keep that, to know that we're in the key of A. Then I'm just playing a high, two octaves higher A. And then I'm using my hand. We went over this technique. It's called the piano ballad technique. Okay, and I'm gonna record that to the track. Let's do that. I'm only gonna record it once because I don't need to record it 1,000 times. Since I'm playing the same thing, it's a little lagged due to the video setup, so let's pull those notes over manually. Snap to grid none. Okay, so here's what it looks like. I meant to give you the octave view. So we're playing two octaves of A with my left hand, then the right hand's with my pinky, I'm playing a higher octave A, two octaves higher. Then with my thumb, I'm hitting E. You don't have to do it that way. You can space your, you can do it with your pointer finger as well. I'm not gonna go over that technique. We have videos on that. It'd probably be more efficient to use your pointer finger and then your middle finger for F. Then thumb for A. So that's how I was playing it. Okay, now I'm gonna add an ending to it. I forgot what I played before, so let's clone that out, hitting shift, holding shift, and then left click and drag. Now for pattern 11, I wanna record an ending to it. So it's not just the same thing over and over again. So I think I went, okay, so I'm gonna go ba, 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 whoops. We're gonna do something like that. I might edit it depending on how I feel, but let's record just on that last section. And let's hit record, notes and automation. Let me get my hands ready. Oh no, I forgot. We don't have to, thinking I'm recording audio in the playlist. I might change that last note. I don't think I like it. Now for whatever reason, it didn't record the bottom notes. For whatever reason. I think it's because we locked it into that bar and I played it a little earlier. So anyway, let's hit Alt-Q to quantize those notes since they're occurring before the bar section, so it didn't pick up the note value. And also the notes are a little bit early. I'm gonna pull that up to E instead of D. Sounds better. Notice that, you know, it's a little hesitant and that creates the humanized feel. So usually you want to play stuff by hand if you can. If not, it's okay. The world's not over. Let's add a couple effects to this grand piano. Firstly, let's check the actual plugin, make sure we don't have any effects like the FX drive A or FX drive B. Now this piano has reverb built in, so we're going to turn that off. I usually don't like in plugin effects, period. It really depends on the company, but let's go to pattern 10. Let's open up a fruity delay. We're gonna create a subtle ping pong delay. So it goes left and right. Let's turn our pan width all the way up. Turn the volume down, however. Now here it's okay to have a triplet bounce because remember the rappers are gonna be da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You know, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So it's okay to fill that gap. This one's set to 3 steps, which means it's gonna be 3/4 timing delay. Okay, so if you didn't want it 3/4 timing, you're going to set it to 4 or 2. Those are usually your options, but let's set it to 3. I'm looking at the value up here just in case you didn't know where I'm getting the numbers from. It tells you the value in the top left. So that adds to that gap that we're trying to create. Let's also go to Fruity Reverb 2, and we're going to use little bit of reverb. Now I'm going to use the high cut to cut out higher frequencies above 2k. We don't want the reverb to get in the way of the vocals. And also I'm going to pull the wet level down so it's not as aggressive. see if we change our root note for our 808 to A versus C. Let's see how it changes. Now notice it still sounds okay. It's not out of key. It's just a different feel when we have our bass at C versus A. So let's pull it either down to A or up to the A up here. And then let's see the difference. Let's hear the difference. Notice it sounds a lot more engaged. Let's try the lower octave, control down. That's a little too rumbly. It even sounds out of key at that low of a frequency. So I'm going to pull it up to the A versus the C note so that it matches our musicality. So, you know, this all ties together. This is why you need to understand music theory. If you don't understand music theory, you never know why your song doesn't sound cohesive. It's much deeper than just guessing which notes sound right. There's a formula to it. So you can go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory to learn a lot more about that. Let's hear it now. I'm going to turn the clap up a little bit. And we're going to do some top secret techniques here. Usually people would stop there and say, okay, the beat's done. Well, let's open up GMS and let's go to Banks, User, Default. And we're going to turn up the noise parameter. I'm going to turn off Oscillator 1. I'm not even sure if we can do that here, actually. Can we turn this off? This might not work. Because what we need to do is turn off Oscillator 1. Let's just not use this plugin. Let's replace this with 3X OSC. Let's turn off oscillators 2 and 3, and let's go to the DICE, which is stands for random, which stands for white noise. So we get that scratchy tone. Listen, this is track 11. Let's go to parametric EQ 2. I'm going to cut out some of the low end using a high pass filter. So let's left click, drag that shape to a high pass filter, and cut out some of those low frequencies. Now you're like, why would we ever use this sound? I remember I used to think that as well. But it has its creative uses. So what I'm going to do is... let's do it on A because I want to do something. I'm going to show you a cool technique. Let's drag this out for 4 bars and I'm going to have this sweep in volume. So I want to go, you know, over time. So let's right click. Let's go back to our channel rack. Let's right click the channel volume, go to create automation clip. Let's zoom in a bit and we're going to change our snap to grid to a half beat. Probably it might be something smaller than a half beat, but let's just see. Let's zoom in. So I wanted to start, let's right click, copy the value firstly before you do anything. Always copy the initial value so you don't lose it. Pull this down and then we're gonna go figure out where we want it to swell up in volume. So that's a little too early. So let's pull this over. So I wanted to go, you know, when the open hi-hat's playing, like right here, that's when I want this volume to swell. So I have it on that third beat. So it sounds almost like a shaker. So we're going to slice this out, measure every 4 increments so you have a good even slice, and then we're going to highlight it and hit Control B so we can latch paste. So we don't have to keep, you know, doing the same shape over and over again. And we can use that subtle energy as an energy boost. So we can also add some effects. Let's add some reverb to it. The reverb is giving it a little more tail just to fill up all the dead space. Let's turn that volume down. Now one more technique I want to do is go to parametric EQ 2. This is optional, but you can add what's called a resonance point by pulling up another point using your scroll wheel or the bottom here where it says BW, stands for bandwidth. Let's tighten that. We can give this a tone by pulling up that frequency spot. So what I'm trying to do is match this with the music. And another cool thing you could do is actually right click the panning, create an automation clip. So I can have this pan left and right over time. So let's do that. I'm gonna have it pan here. I mean, you can get as creative as you want. You don't have to do these exact same things. Just these are just ideas, but this is how you kind of liven up background stuff. So let's hit Control B. So now it feels like the song is actually moving versus this very static thing, even though we have dynamic. I want to hear what this would sound like an octave lower, so I'm going to hit Control down. I think that sounds more their style if we pull it down an octave. Now, a quick trick, let's say you want to create an octave higher without creating a whole new pattern. Just highlight the four patterns in a row. We're going to go to the playlist options, go to edit, merge pattern clips. That's going to make this one new pattern. We're going to go in, go to edit pattern, and all I have to do is hit control up to pull it up an octave. So we go from low octave to high octave. So it creates a nice contrast if that's what you want. So now we need ambience and we need some kind of synth thing in the background. So let's open up GMS. Here's where you get to be super creative. Okay, let's go to bank, let's go to user, default. Now what I like to do is program sounds into effects so I can hear them live. So let's go to track 12. I'm going to open up Fruity Delay. I'm going to leave it on the triplet timing or three steps settings by default. Let's go to ping pong, turn the pan width up. I actually want to hear the volume, so I'm leaving the volume pretty high of the delay and turning the feedback tail up so the delay has a long time where it's going to be active. So now when I play a note, actually that might be a little too aggressive on the volume. Let's turn the volume down a bit more. Let's cut the feedback down so it's not as loud for that long. Okay, now let's go to Fruity Reverb. Cutting out those high frequencies for this specific song. And I'm gonna pull up the decay tail a little bit more. To about 2 seconds or so. Okay, so now when I build a sound, I'm going to hear it going through those effects. And also, let's add a fruity phaser. We might as well for a little more creativity sound. Let's pull the phaser, though. We're going to pull this up. You can use your mouse wheel to do it and just scroll. Or you can click the down arrow and hit U for up and D for down if you want to rearrange your processing chain. And yes, it does make a difference when you're mixing. Okay. Okay, so what I want is a very plucky sine wave sound. So let's change this waveform to a sine wave. Let's go to our ADSR, our attack, decay, sustain, release envelope. Let's pull down sustain. We want it to pluck, so it has to die over time. And that stands for decay. So let's tell it to decay. And that will give it a very... And now we can do whatever we want. So I'm just going to play around on the keyboard till something pops up, an idea. And I'm just gonna record it. I think I just like the bum 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 bum, what we've already done. So let's record that. Notes and automation. So we're just kind of accenting what we already have. Same technique we did with the piano. Now, of course, the notes are going to be a little early due to the video. I meant to hit Control A so we can move everything at once. Whoops. Pull those over. Now these are, you know, let's just hit, actually the last one's a little early at the end. Let's move that over. Let's pull it up an octave. I just want to hear what it would sound like. Control up. Okay, let's do the same thing we did before. Let's highlight this, let's clone it, let's hit shift, pull it over. And then we're gonna make this unique. So it's a new pattern, let's go to edit pattern, let's hit control up so it plays an octave higher. And it will match the piano. Now this is a little out of time, so what I might do is quantize it. So let's hit control, I don't wanna overly quantize, it's just this note. So let's highlight it and hit Alt Q. First note, because when you play it early it sounds offbeat. So as long as you have it either quantized or a little bit after the downbeat, it won't sound offbeat. So that's the trick. For whatever reason, playing a note earlier sounds like it's out of offbeat versus when you play it a little bit later it sounds in the groove. So I want to be careful with that. So let's add those effects. Now usually I don't use Gross Beat, I use a different plugin, but I'm going to show you on Gross Beat, which is an image line plugin. Notice it says when I hit Control S, it says one plugin used in this project is in demo version and it won't save. And I hit Control S by habit, so it's going to keep pulling up that message. Anyway, what you want to do is go to the green tab, not the yellow one. So if you click on each tab, it gives you a different parameter you can modulate. What we want to do here is go to the green one, which controls time. Okay, and then the yellow controls volume. Let's go to green, which controls time. We're going to change our snap to grid to 1/4. We're going to right click some points in. Now this starts off blocky because it assumes you want to create a pulsating effect, which is fine. But that's not what we want to create. So let's actually delete that point. Let's pull the ending point down. I just wanted to show you can create points. And let's right click and change the mode to single curve. So it gives you a curvature. Now you can actually tell the song how the time should bend. So let's pull it up to this curvature. So it will go regular pitch, and then it'll go down in pitch. Now some people, to tighten it up, since it's slowing down like the whole last section, to tighten it up, some people like to add points either here or here, so that it only grabs the ending for the time. For the time pitch. Now that might be too fast, so let's delete that. Okay, now you can pull it down further if you want. But it's gonna reverse and re-loop. It's a little confusing to get used to if you don't understand bars and beats and all this type of stuff. I'm not gonna sit here and confuse you with it. I generally don't even use this plugin as far as creations. Not saying that it's not good, however, I used to use it a lot. So anyway, people are like, okay, well, how do you take the effect off? So you need to right click, create an automation clip on the mix level, which is this knob here. And now you need to tell it when to turn on. So let's turn it off for the majority of the time. And I want it to occur on that last bar section, you know, at the last fourth segment. So let's go here. That's not even the fourth segment. Can't count. Let's pull that over. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Pull this over. Okay, so it doesn't continue to play. You have to automate when Gross Beat is doing its thing. Now, also, they do mutes. If you wanted to do a full project mute, you want to go to your master track, right click on the master fader, right click and create automation clip. And you can create mutes this way. So when you mute the master track, however, you mute everything. So if you have vocals in here, it's going to be muted. If you have stuff like that, it's going to be muted. So generally speaking, I don't use a master volume fader for most work, unless you're creating a fade out. But here, I just wanted to show you, if you're just working on the beat, let's go to snap to grid, half beat. Now, let's say you had vocals in this project and you only wanted to mute the beat versus the vocals. You would have to route all these to a track called beat. So you just highlight all your tracks and you go to a blank track, you right click and go to route to this track only. And that will send every one of those tracks directly to that one track. And then that track goes to the master and you can automate the fader for that track instead. If you're confused about that, routing and different things, go to busyworksbeats.com/mixingacademy. We go over routing, we go over a lot of different things in mixing. So let's say you wanted to add a mute in here. We need to copy the values from the initial point, right click and copy, or hit C. And let's right click, paste. I'm gonna create a little box, a mute box. So sometimes you don't hear the pitch bend, or you can move the mute somewhere else. So let's pull the mute over. So I mean, you can get as creative as you want. Now what you don't realize is that what most engineers deal with are stems. So when you're dealing with MIDI, this doesn't make any sense because you're not used to working with audio. So what an engineer would do, the way they sound is because they sample themselves. Okay, so let's turn off gross beat for a second. I want to show you something. If I record here to here, for example, I'm going to compare the two. I'm about to get rid of gross beat. Since we already showed you gross beat, I'm going to get rid of it because that message is annoying. Okay. Let's get rid of the automation as well. Okay, so now let's go back, record bars 7 to 8. Let's go to the master track, open up Edison. It's going to give you a completely different sound when you do it this way. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is actually let's record a little bit more so it doesn't loop back on itself. Actually, let's record. I'm going to move this over so it leaves a gap. Let's go to Edison. Let's go to record. Now, you wouldn't do this if you were the engineer. You would have the wave stems. So I just want to show you what it would be in the eyes of an audio engineer. Let's record on input, the master track. Go back, hit stop a couple times, hit play. Okay, so that's what they would be seeing. Okay, so now let's drag that into the playlist. I want to show you how they would do it their way. You know, why it sounds different than if you use MIDI. It's because MIDI leaves tails. It leaves effects tails. It doesn't stutter completely. So let's move this over, snap to grid none, pull this over, and make sure it just lines up with the tempo. That's all I'm trying to do here. So let me slide this back a bit. So here's what the engineer would do. And again, this is a step people do after the beat's done, after the vocals are done. So it's not a production thing to do this. Let's go to snap to grid, half beat, just so we can slice a little more precisely. So let's say I want to slice here to here. What they do is they slice there to there, right? And they delete the excess and just clone it on itself. So here's what it would sound like. So it goes a dun, 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 and you could feel it kind of going back. It has a completely different feel than the beat we had before. So let's compare the two. Let's loop these so you can hear them back to back. Just to show you the difference between dealing with audio and MIDI. It's a completely different game because you're telling it to stop immediately, whatever is happening. So the effects don't continue and different things. So let's zoom in. We're gonna listen to the MIDI versus the audio. Now let me make sure that was our ending bar. Yeah, it was. Completely different feel. You hear the tone specifically here. Let's focus in here because this is the key. Listen to the piano kind of rev back on itself. You can hear it swell back and forth. Completely different than the MIDI. So it's two different worlds. And that's usually what they do. They do 1-2 da-da-dum, or they'll do 1-2 1-2, or whatever the pattern may be. So you can do this a billion different ways. 1, 2, boom, 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 and then the tape stop. So that's usually how they do it. They don't do it with the MIDI. So here a tape stop would occur. Okay, that's how they do it, not in the MIDI. So I just wanted to show you the difference in the importance of audio. So don't think audio is useless. Wanted to take it a step further, we're just adding ambience to the track. So nothing spectacular from the, well, not, I'm not gonna say it's not spectacular, but nothing major from this point on. It's just your creativity. Let's go to user default. I'm gonna use a super saw. I'm gonna speed through this because I don't want to spend too much time on it. Let's pull up the voices to 8 voices, detune them to about 40%. Let's pull out the stereo width. Let's add a low pass filter to cut out or muffle the sound, and let's turn up resonance. Play your low octave. Okay. Now you don't have to get Drake-ish with it, but that's, we're trying to create an ambience. Now what I'm going to do here is play A at a really low note, and I'm going to filter it using an EQ. We're going to cut out a lot of the frequency, and I'll show you what I'm going to do in a second. So let's add this in. This is optional, you don't have to do it this way. Sounds a little aggressive, so also you can lower the cutoff, which is probably what I'm gonna do. It's too aggressive, too bitey. So let's cut out some more high frequency. But, you know, I'm not trying to make it a Drake bass. In this case, though, let me mute the 808 for a second. Just to make like a contrast section, okay? You can call it a bridge, you can call it whatever you want. Let's just have something different than the 808 pattern. So now I'm gonna go to the mixer, go to parametric EQ2. I'm gonna cut out the majority of the mids and pull up the highs. So the mids don't get played. It's a really weird technique to use, but we're so not used to hearing it that it feels ambient. Another technique you can use is to take out the mono signal, but I'm not going to get too complicated in this video. Now let's add a fruity compressor just to keep it tamed. Again, a little bit beyond the scope of the video, but you can learn more at busyworksbeats.com/mixingacademy. Let's give this a 2-to-1 ratio. Just want to keep it tamed. So that gives us contrast for the 808. So when the 808 comes back, we're like, yes, the 808's back. So I'll add a vocal idea to this. Hopefully I have enough rhyme words for the Migos. They rap really, really fast. But hopefully I, you know, show you their production style as well as show you a song demo to show you that it's a lot more than just the beat. You know, it's their style added to it as well as that engineering technique I showed you. So that's something you have to do post-production. Not during production. You could do it during production, but it's probably best you wait until the vocals are laid down to do all those edits and tape stops and, you know, the repetitious type of deals. one thing I meant to do before I continue. Oh, you know what? I think I was tricking myself. Never mind. Taking out the hi-hats. And leaving that kind of that noise sound that we built. So again, when I go back and do post-production and do those stutters and tape stops, it's going to sound completely different, especially when I add the vocals and when I mix it. So you have to remember you're dealing with raw material. Until the vocals are laid and until you fully mix and master a song, it's always going to sound like raw material for the most part, unless you learned how to mix and master. If you want to learn how to mix and master, I know that's not in the scope of this video, but go to busyworksbeats.com/MAC. I'll leave a link below the video, so don't worry about that. But if you want these project files for free, just go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio and you'll get these project files for free. So you can click that link below as well to get these project files. Okay, so again, I'm going to lay a vocal and mix it. And we'll see the final product in the next couple seconds. Thanks for watching today. It's busyworksbeats.com. Coke and the rapper, I speed it up. Y'all was just saying we filthy. Murder and beast and we guilty. Y'all was just talking regardless. Numbers is running, you talking. Coke and the rapper, I speed it up. Y'all was just saying we filthy. Murder and beast and we guilty. Burner is on me, it's filthy. Chop it, it's chopping, we speed it up. Step in the building, I heat it up. Y'all gonna say you wasn't deep enough. Funny cause I get way deep in her. Squared up with the box, I beat it up. Yo, watch on clock, it ain't freezing up. Rollie ain't taking your freezing up. Copping and dropping, I'm speeding up. Coking the rapper, I speed it up. Put the white on white like pizza. Rolling in West with a diva. Black, white floors, no zebra. High up the slice with no Keisha. Ain't talking about crack when I come for the bag. Where your real friends at when you need them. Ain't talking about sex when I come for the cash. Talking meal stacked up, no features. Coking the rapper, I speed it up. Y'all was just saying we filthy. Murder and beast and we guilty. Y'all was just talking regardless. Numbers is running, you jogging. Coking the rapper, I speed it up. Y'all was just saying we filthy. Murder and beast and we guilty. Burner is on me, it's filthy. Chop it, it's chopping, we speed it up. Create complete compositions with comprehension. Master music theory. Visit busyworksbeats.com/musictheory for your free bonuses and free music theory tutorials. Professional mixing secrets finally revealed. Get 3 free videos straight from the new Mixing Academy complete course package at busyworksbeats.com/Mac. Want to learn how to make beats like the pros? Join now for free at busyworksbeats.com and learn the secrets of the pros.